I'm reminded of another thing in your book, which was just fascinating to me because I find him to be such an interesting guy, is you had this meeting with Steven Spielberg and and George Lucas shows up. And I think you were unaware that George Lucas was going to be there or was going to pop by. And, well, you can relate what happens in this story, which is pretty startling.
Yeah. What happened was, so this was 2000, it was the beginning of 2012. And I don't know if people remember, but there was a theory at the time that in December of 2012, the world was going to end. Because that's when I believe the Mayan calendar, ended, which is in retrospect, a shaky theory to be making real decisions based
they
on.
They were right about everything else.
So, like Conan said, me and Evan were called into a meeting, with Steven Spielberg, which was a real treat and, an amazing, I'd met him a couple times, very in passing, but it was a thrill, you know? And we got to the meeting and we were waiting in his office for him. It's like a doctor's office. They take you in first and you wait for them to come in. And he came in with George Lucas, which was mind blowing. Wow. Like you it just they're there together. It truly, you know, for like a nerdy kid, like one of the most amazing things I've ever seen in my entire life. And at which point Spielberg, if I remember, like, it's kind of like making phone calls and doing some stuff as he's like, I need a few minutes, as George Lucas sits down and talks to me and Evan, at which point, very quickly, the conversation turns to, like, how's it going? Not great. We're nearing the end of 2012, and the world is going to end, essentially. Me and Evan are like, is he joking? A question that still haunts me to this day, and I think I know the answer, is was he joking? I really don't think. It did not appear he was joking.
Oh, no.
So we tried to prod, and we're making jokes. It's like, oh, like, what's supposed to happen? It's like, oh, a giant fault is going to, you know, earthquake.
No, he's very seriously saying, yeah, it's a fault line.
It's a fault line. I'm like, oh, good thing the Skywalker Ranch is on the other side of the fault line. And he's like, oh, that's not a coincidence. Like, and we're like, oh, like, what?
He's thought it all out.
He's really thought it all out. And so at which point, we making a joke like, oh, well, like, if you got a spaceship to escape Earth, like, you know, can we get a seat on that thing? And he was like, no.
Oh, no.
Which, again, like, it makes me think he wasn't joking, because if you were joking, you would just say yes to go, like, to at least placate us by granting our wish to go on the spaceship. But no, he said no. And thank God. But yeah, and again, to this day, I am confounded and plagued by that story. I don't know if he had a spaceship. If he did, I don't know if he was on it that day, but it must have been a weird morning.
Yeah. Yeah.
Have you met him?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Do you buy that maybe he thought that was real?
I think it was real. You know what? I would say Spielberg's reaction would probably tell you everything you need to know.
Spielberg was a little bit like, he was kind of like, sorry for my slightly weird friend.
Right. So that tells you that he was absolutely serious. The last time I ran into George Lucas, and I ran into him, and he was like, hello, Conan. I was like, oh, hello, George, good to see you. And he's like, good to see you. And I think at the end of the conversation, it was brief, but I just said, I've got to, you know, go. I got a show to do, you know, show to tape. And he said, you don't tape a show, you're retired. And I said, no. And he went, yes, you are. Like, he knows that, you know, so yeah, I'm not on a network, but I'm not retired, but, you know, so I'm not whatever, but he was telling me that I was retired. And I was saying, well, I'm not, I have a show and I also did this and that and that. And he was kind of like, no, 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 no. Almost as if I was, isn't it sad that Conan doesn't know?
Someone should have told him that a long time ago.
I have a similar, I actually had heard a similar story where.
That I'm retired?
No, yeah, exactly. That you're retired. I don't know what I'm doing here. And I want to
Conan, where have you been? I haven't seen you since Vancouver when I took that
photo. Thank you for coming out of retirement to record this episode.
I am the J.D. Salinger of comedy.
I had heard a story that George Lucas was on the set of the Solo movie and went up to the lead actor, whose name is Alden. I don't know.
Ehrenreich or something.
Ehrenreich, yeah, which Alden Ehrenreich, yeah. And went up to him and went, hey, congratulations on Baby Driver. And he said, I'm not in Baby Driver. To which I was told George Lucas responded, are you sure?
Yes, that's what he told me. He essentially told me,
he doubted.
Don't you realize, Conan, you don't make shows anymore, and you haven't since you left NBC. And I was saying, no, I do make, no, you don't. And so, no, you know what? I'm starting to think he's right.
Like, he's right. This isn't happening. The world ended in 2012, and this is all like a weird echo of George Lucas's consciousness that we're living
in. I think, yeah, the world did end, and we're living, he survived, and we're living in his mind.
This is all a construct. If anyone could come up with this, George Lucas. The guy's a world builder. He does good world building.